I describe it more as a mustardy yellow, so not your clean, zesty, electric yellow, but more of a deep mustardy yellow, which I personally love. Hi guys, it's Beth. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with a watch review for you guys, and I'll be reviewing the Rolex Oyster Perpetual 41mm yellow dial, so stay tuned. So I'm going to be talking about Rolex's 2020 line of release with the new Oyster Perpetuals. We actually picked up this watch early last weekend, but instead of doing a watch pickup for you guys, I wanted to switch it up a bit and do something a bit more casual. So a quick story on the watch. We were actually lucky enough to see all the new Rolex 2020 watches back in early September, and these new Oysters caught my eye, as I'm sure they did for everyone else, well, because of their fun, bright colors.
They're very different from what Rolex normally does, especially on an Oyster. I'm used to seeing the muted, more classic colors like champagne, black, white, blue, pearl. But when I saw news of these new, fun, bright colors, I was intrigued. After I saw and tried on all the fun new colors, I was hooked on the yellow and turquoise. I actually tried so hard to love the orange because orange is my favorite color, but the orange dial actually pulled more red than orange, and I just personally couldn't love it. I also found the yellow to be a perfect balance for me and my husband. It's not overly masculine nor feminine like the turquoise would be. I also want to mention that I specifically chose the 41mm out of personal preference because I prefer a bigger dial that's easier to read and tell the time at a quick glance, which is harder to do on a small dial. This is also one of the rare timepieces my husband and I will be sharing, which is why I'm switching things up a bit today with showing you guys me resizing the bracelet as a female. Resizing bracelets is something you can easily do at home if you plan on sharing a nice piece with a partner, and is not a requirement upon purchase from an AD, which is something I wanted to address from the interesting comments and assumptions from my first video. Removing stickers is, but sometimes you get lucky and some are still on there. Anyways, I think both the 39mm and 41mm are stunning choices for females, so you really can't go wrong with either, though the pink dial is the only color that does not come in a 41.
I next want to move on to what I love about the watch. So of course, my favorite and most standout feature of the watch is its yellow dial. I chose the yellow over the turquoise because I tend to gravitate towards warmer colors. I overall wear a warmer color palette between my clothes and accessories, and I found the yellow to be a perfect fit. The yellow's a fun eye grabber while also seamlessly blending in with the aesthetics I like to go for. I was glad I was able to see the colors early on in person. I know colors tend to get lost and kind of change according to lighting and different filters online, and I definitely wanted to see the exact shade and pull of yellow that this watch has in person. I describe it more as a mustardy yellow, so not your clean, zesty, electric yellow, but more of a deep mustardy yellow, which I personally love. It's a perfect complement for my outfits that tend to be warmer in tones, and also a great match for my golden olive skin tone. It's a watch I'd grab when I need an instant fun pop of color, but also when I want a timepiece that's casual and easy, but also fun and bright at the same time.
I want to next get into why the yellow OP is a great piece for females. Historically, the Rolex Oyster Perpetual is an iconic watch. The famous Oyster case is a symbol of waterproofness and robustness. It was created in 1926 and became the world's first waterproof case for a wristwatch, a milestone in watchmaking history. The OP's got no complications. It strictly tells you the time, so it's a very easy and simple watch. But at that, this yellow OP isn't your common casual watch, but rather a fun standout one. It's super lightweight, so it's not bulky and doesn't feel like too much on the wrist. I personally also think this new 2020 collection for Rolex is a great reach and option for females, which I mentioned in my first video where I first talk about Rolex's 2020 release. The fun, colorful dials are different than the classic watch looks and can even sway more towards fashion pieces, quirky accents, and pops of color. There are tons more options for women in this line, especially for women who prefer easy, clean, dressy pieces rather than sporty watches. I think the yellow is a perfect summer piece that reflects warm, long, sunny days, but that can also carry you through the warm autumn palette, as well as add just a touch of brightness to the winter season.
I think Rolex did a phenomenal job with the Oyster Perpetuals in this 2020 release. They kept the classic look of an OP for watch lovers who just want an easy, clean dial, and cater to those who prefer a classic look with the black, blue, and champagne colors, but also give an option to those who want a fun standout color like the yellow, orange, turquoise, and pink. Even if the yellow doesn't call to you, there are all the other colors that I feel will suit everyone in one way or another. I feel like there's a color for everyone that will specifically and uniquely complement your skin tone, your styling taste, your color preferences, and your aesthetic. That's my take on the new Rolex Oyster Perpetual Yellow Dial. If you liked the video, give it a cute little thumbs up and let me know down in the comments which OP color is your favorite. Follow me on my Instagram for all updates and don't forget to subscribe to see more. Thank you guys for watching, stay safe and healthy for the holidays, and I'll see you guys soon on my next video. Hi guys, it's Beth.